This is an LG non-inverter air conditioner circuit board, which has come in for repair. Typically, normal PCBs have a specific setup, but LG provides two wires here that are for the fan motor, and it uses a slightly different motor. Additionally, I want to tell you that the voltage regulator used in this unit is often not available. You can see the number on it, but it is not easily available in the market. You have to find it specially from somewhere. Apart from this, I'll also explain how its system works and how the motor operates, as well as other components. We'll be repairing it as well. Physically, if we examine it, you can see that its capacitor is swollen, so it's completely non-functional at the moment. Additionally, it's possible that the switching IC is also faulty, or there could be an issue with one of the diodes. So, let me first explain the problem in detail. The electricity flows in from this point, and when the relay switches, it connects to the other point. And this is the neutral point. You can see there's a fuse installed here, and currently this fuse is burned out. I haven't yet removed the fuse for repair. After this, you can see there's a capacitor here, and there is one capacitor before it and another capacitor after it. These capacitors are for handling spikes. Then you can see there is a line filter. Again, there is a capacitor installed here. All these components are meant to control spikes. Any fluctuations are absorbed by them. After this, you can see a ZNR installed here to protect the circuit from voltage transients and surges. Then you can see that bridge rectification is not present. Instead, diodes have been used here. A bridge rectifier has been created here, and this is where AC is converted to DC. After the conversion, you can see an NTC sensor installed here. The electricity passes through it and enters this capacitor to smooth the voltages. After this, you can see a switching IC here, which is the LNK500PN. And here, you can see that there are four pins on this side, labeled 1, 2, 3, and 4, all of which are source pins. In addition to this, you can see that the pin number 5 is the drain pin, and there is nothing connected to pin number 6. Pin number 7 is also a source pin, and the last pin, pin number 8, is known as the feedback or control pin, where control voltages come in. Now, where do these voltages come from? There is an optocoupler here, which provides the control voltages. After this, the switching IC turns on the supply when the control voltages come in, as there isn't much else special about this circuit. It mainly has one feedback. After that, it switches on. So when it is turned on, chopper here generates electricity. When this happens, DC to DC conversion takes place, and then we get voltages on the other side. You can see that the chopper has only two pins on this side, two on the other side. The voltages will come from here, and we should get 12 volts here. So this will only work when 12 volts come here. After this, you can see that one pin is coming from this side and another pin from this side. Let me show you. There is a jumper installed here. So through this jumper, you can see that voltages are being generated here. The voltages come in at 12 volts input, and we get 5 volts output, which operate this microcontroller and other components. You can also see that there are three ULN2003 ICs installed here, which works to control different swing motors and to switch on the relay. In addition, there are several motors in this unit. It has motors for horizontal and vertical swings in the air conditioner. All these components are installed specifically for these motors. Later, I will tell you how to install the second voltage regulator, because if you install it in this position, it gets damaged. The fan motor has two wires coming out from here. These are just the line and neutral wires. This pin is directly connected to the line. One pin here is neutral, as you can see. If we look at the other side, we see the neutral wire coming in. And here, you can see there is a line filter installed. After the line filter, the wire continues, and then you can see that a direct wire has been given to this pin. Now let's talk about the phase. The phase operates through this entire system, which I will explain to you. You can see there is an optocoupler here, which is operated by the microcontroller. The microcontroller directly turns it on and off, and it controls a triac. When the triac is on, then the fan turns on as well. And when the fan motor has the line and neutral coming out from here, its capacitor is connected alongside it. If you have experience with this, you'll notice that the capacitor is often connected directly to where the line and neutral go, allowing the motor to start functioning. In this way, the speed is also controlled from here, because the more voltage is given to the triac, the more it will open. This means the speed can be slow or fast. If the voltage is low, the speed will be slow, and if the voltage is high, the speed will increase. This is how the control is managed. Now, let's talk about the voltage regulator here, which is not easily available in the market. It can be quite difficult to find. For this reason, you can use a normal voltage regulator, and I will explain what you need to do. I have a 7805 voltage regulator, which is easily available in the market and quite inexpensive. Now, let's look at the difference between this voltage regulator and the other one. This pin is the input for the regulator. The center pin is the ground. The last pin is the output. And if you install this other voltage regulator in the circuit, its pins are different. I'll explain how they're arranged. This is the input, this is the ground, and this is the output. If you connect it in this way, it will damage the entire circuit. So what you need to do is very simple. You have to connect it in reverse. When you connect it in reverse, the connections will change, and the whole system will work the same way. If you connect it correctly, then the whole PCB will get damaged. This is how you can work on it easily. Now let's change this capacitor, and then we will turn it on to see if it works. If it doesn't turn on, then we will check the switching and the voltage to troubleshoot and fix it. Now you can see that I have changed the capacitor, but even after that, it is still burning the fuse. You can see that I also changed the fuse, but I directly checked it, which is not a good practice. However, now I will check it again in front of you to identify what the problem is and why it keeps burning the fuse. Well, there's a problem with the diodes. Let me check them for you. First, we will look at the bridge rectifier diodes. When we check this diode, it seems to be fine. If we check it in reverse polarity, it shows okay. Now let's check the second diode. So this diode is showing zero voltage drop. If we change the polarity and check again, it still shows zero. Let's check the next diode as well, and you can see that this diode is also showing zero. This means that the rectifier diodes are damaged, and usually two on the same side fail at once. So two diodes in this circuit are defective. We will also replace these, and here you can see that it has been fixed. I have also changed the diodes. Now I have supplied electricity to it, and let's see if it turns on. As you can see, the light has turned on, and it has started working. It has also produced its output, so the PCB is completely functional now. Click on the left or right thumbnail to watch our next videos, and subscribe. Thank you.